The first partner and the Governor's Council for Career Education were able to see the students working firsthand with real-world technology, learning quite literally how to build the future of California.
So we're building the STEM pipeline through programs like this, and this what Sierra College is doing needs to be replicated across the state.
The mechatronics degree at Sierra College combines the hands and the brain, creating a job training program that translates into well-paying careers across the state. But as the Chief Deputy Cabinet Secretary and Senior Advisor for Cradle to Career, Ben Cheetah, explains, it's not just about the technical skills.
They're learning durable, future-proof, and very human skills. Mm-hmm. So they're learning collaboration, problem-solving. They're learning interpersonal relationships. Mm-hmm. They're learning teamwork.
A tour of the vast work coming out of the mechatronics programs included demonstrations.
Right now, it's a precise plan.
Conversations with students achieving big things in the automotive, mechanical, and manufacturing fields. And time with the first partner and other state leaders working towards more opportunity in education.
Meeting all the students, the entrepreneurs, the engineers, the innovators, it gives me hope. These young people, some older, some mid-career, switching careers, they are our future.
Something Siebel-Newsom loved to see were the women involved in these STEM field clubs and degrees. She spoke with Erica Snow, a member of the automotive club who just won a prestigious award.
The club, the girls, the young women were telling me, was not open to women before. And Erica kind of was very alone, but then because Erica was there, this whole notion, if you can see it, you could be it, she helped to create a culture by virtue of also the men, the young men respecting her, whereby other women joined.
Some graduates work for statewide and even national companies after graduation, but many of them keep their skills local at places like Blue Diamond Almonds, Bosch, and the city of Roseville.
Some of them were talking about how they're trying to build industry in this community in particular. So I love that connection to the broader California community because it basically allows us to fill gaps and then create stronger economies, local economies.
The Council for Career Education and the First Partners sees mechatronics as a cost-effective, time-efficient solution for people looking to upskill their current abilities and transition into high-paying, stable careers.
When you're intentional about how you're serving the person, the community, and everybody, then you can actually achieve all those goals all at once, right? Because at the end of the day, these mechatronics programs, the jobs at Bosch, are gonna be good, well-paying jobs that are gonna enable them to put people to put food on their families' tables.
It really excites me about the possibilities for everyone, diverse communities, but especially women who have been left out of the STEM pipeline and STEM careers, and this is a solution.
Another takeaway the first partner mentioned today was how these skills are transferable to lots of different industries, and they'll be able to adapt and even lead the charge in many ways when it comes to AI and automation. So she says these skills will help students get jobs we don't even know exist yet.